contract, that makes banks contract. So right now, all of this, this debt ceiling is a perfect example. What a contrived story, okay? That the clock's ticking, and all of a sudden, 24 hours after a certain point, okay?
That was your speech the other day.
That was the most disappointing sentence I've ever heard a president speak.
Which one was that?
That was the point he made, that if the Republicans don't kowtow to this, we won't have, be able to write the check to Social Security.
There's no more money.
And my answer to that is, wait a minute, Mr. President.
There's no money.
All the people in America that paid into this system for all these years, are you telling me that you got to go borrow the money to pay off what should be in the bank? Okay.
That's what you're about all the discretionary, all the discretionary spending you could drop out?
Sure, exactly.
What do you see as the primary function of government?
It starts with national defense. It starts to provide protection and services to the people that can't be done on a local level. I'm somebody that comes from the view that individuals should be responsible for their own action. Self-reliance is a key word I use because that's the way I was brought up. From there, I like local governments to be in control of things like education and neighborhoods. I think the states have a unique role in highway construction and things of that nature. Public safety is a local, generally a local issue. You know, most everything should be left to the states. You know, and what's happened is the federal government has exploded. And the biggest sin I think that's happened is the fact that they bought off the states by printing more money. That was that stimulus program. And then look what Governor Scott's now having to deal with. He's not cutting back, okay? He's balancing the budget, okay? And the $2 billion gap that he faced when he became governor was $2 billion worth of Washington, D.C. stimulus money, okay? And one of the questions I have for some of the people that are in the race for the Republican that have spent this last decade in Tallahassee is, the main question I have for these gentlemen, why did we spend every cent that we got over the last 10 years? Okay, tell me why we did it. Okay, we knew times were good. Okay, why did our budget go from $50 billion to $70 billion? Okay, this idea that government has to spend every dime and we're never going to have a rainy day, we don't think that way. Okay, if we did, we wouldn't have the opportunity to retire and live in places like Sarasota, Florida. So why does government feel they have to spend every penny they get? And then when you think about the federal, they spend that plus 40 cents more, okay? And I like and respect the people that I'm running against in the Republican primary, but I have one question for those gentlemen. They're in Tallahassee for the last 10 years. Why did we spend every dime we sent up to them? Can you explain that to them? Why did we do that?
I think at this point, Democrats, Republicans, and I am so disgusted with the Republicans, too. There's none of them that's really saying, you know, God, he's doing that. They don't do anything when they were behind closed doors on the House paper saying that. Well, that was terrible. I don't think anybody has any idea what's going to happen, because I came from England when that thing passes. Okay. They have no idea at all.
Yeah.
But the Republicans need to grow some spine and start saying, no, we're not doing that. And as a people, it's frightening how we've all seen and watched it. And the thing is, brought it to light on this thing with the debt ceiling. I said, well, we'll get blamed. Blamed for what? You'll just lose your job. You won't be voted in again. I'm not here to see that you keep your job.
That's the problem. That's the problem.
No, we're not. I don't care. I don't think you'll lose it tomorrow. But that's what they're saying. It won't be blamed. And these people, 33 years in Congress, I'm saying.
Let me give you my card, because I just think I got a vote. it's one of the reasons I'm running, is because I've had a great career, that I don't need to do this. I have a brand new grandson that I'd love to spend a lot of time with, and I got another grandbaby, I don't know what it is yet, it's on the way, okay? I have three grown children. I have a lovely wife that is looking at me like, you're going to do what? After dragging her through a restaurant career. But I think I have something to add. And I think I come into this race from a different perspective. And as I said, you won't find me being concerned about an election that's 6 years off, you won't find me being worried about trying to make people feel good about my decisions. What you're going to find from me is I'm going to look at the issues. I am principled, I'm fiscal conservative, I'm pro-life, I'm pro-constitution. I'm a business guy, so I've had to deal with immigration. But I have some answers and solutions.
Okay.
We may not always and probably won't always agree 100% of the time, but you will bet if I get elected to the U.S. Senate that you will never be disappointed in my response to you, and I will explain why I did what I have done, okay? And hopefully that we can be friends and we can have a better country. And what we have going on right now in Washington is the most finger-pointing, and it's so frustrating because why? You know what stress is in one's life, okay? It saddens me to know the stress the American people are on. And when the President of the United States gets in front of a camera and threatens the seniors, my mom's 91 years old, she doesn't need the Social Security dollars, I'll tell you that. My dad left her fine, okay? But when the President gets in front of the television and says, be afraid, okay? You might not get your check.
Never let a good crisis go to waste.
But don't outright lie.
And if you didn't got one, create one.
Right.
Okay. You know, if you were in business, you're fired.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? You are out of a job.
And the
because
sad thing is, if people just look at it, none of them have the guts not to send the check back. You send that 50 million seniors. These are people.
Next week, we're demonstrating some street. We're people in the streets. We get out there with the posters.
Good for you.
You're going to see that Obama, no more blank check. And we're going to have another one, stop the Medicare. It doesn't work.
People are smarter than that. And so why do you want to get out front and try to scare people? Okay, informed people are smarter than that. That's why
informed.
I've been
that's
informed.
Yeah. Informed.
Yes,
yeah.
Ma'am. And when I ran for Congress, I enjoyed my meetings with 9-12 groups and Tea Party groups and people like you because not only because I connect with people, because I'm used to being, how's your steak tonight? You know? It's because I come from that kind of background, and I understand it. And I don't know whether who the Tea Party is going to support in this election. You know, nobody should consider themselves a Tea Party candidate. That's for the Tea Party to decide, okay? I'm a Republican, but first of all, I'm an American Floridian, long before I'm a Republican. And I'm a Republican because my views are closely aligned with the Republican Party. Okay, I'm a conservative, I'm a fiscal conservative, I'm a social conservative. I'm also a pragmatic business guy that likes to see things get done. And anything that the United Nations or an initiative that comes out of an organization like that that's currently seated and trying to gain some agenda here in the United States, I appreciate the fact that this has been exposed over the last few months. People are starting to wake up and see, the unions have been doing the same kind of thing for years. The unions, they had a strategy, because I was involved with some folks that were researching what was going on with trade unions. Trade unions about 20 years ago made the decision that they were going to start electing people at city council meetings and local elections, and they were going to gain control of the community base. And that was their way to continue to gain control of the political system. And all of a sudden you started seeing people started running for some of these offices. Well, that initiative that you're speaking about, 21, is in a similar way. They plant a seed someplace, and then they water it, and they fertilize it, and they say it's one thing, and it's really something else. Card check, perfect example. This law...
They haven't been very public as an agenda 21.
No, they don't want to be. They don't want to be.
We had George H.W. Bush signing it in Rio de Janeiro.
What was going on with trade unions? Trade unions about 20 years ago made the decision that they were going to start electing people at city council meetings and local elections, and they were going to gain control of the community base. And that was their way to continue to gain control of the political system. And all of a sudden, you started seeing people starting to get, you know, running for some of these offices. Well, you know, that initiative that you're speaking about, 21, is in a similar way. They plant a seed someplace, and then they water it, and they fertilize it, and they say it's one thing, and it's really something else. Card check, perfect example. This law...
They haven't been very public, has it, Agenda 21?
No, they don't want to be.
You know, we had George H.W. Bush signing it in Rio de Janeiro in 1992. Clinton putting together the President's Council on whatever they called it, Agenda 21 or environmental, whatever. This thing's got its tentacles. I don't know how far you've gotten into it, but between Ikeley and Flair's coming into town, we just convinced the Sarasota County to pull out of Ikeley, and City of Northport just got an earful from some people. Well, how far have you actually studied it? How far have you actually looked into it to see how deep its tentacles are already running?
I would guess that it's well rooted, extremely well rooted.
They're already rooted here in Sarasota. Yeah.
Oh, they're all over.
I'm worried about Dwell Green. Big company here in Sarasota. Yeah, and they want to monitor the electrical system. If you buy an appliance, they want to know how energy efficient it is. You fill out the application, you give them the right to check your electric. It's really funny. This is right here in Sarasota.
This is what these people are actually doing.
Yeah. Talk about Big Brother.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's something you may want to really dig into because it is in cities and it's everywhere. I mean, you know, paved roads are not sustainable. Do you know that? Grazing cattle are not sustainable.
Horse and buggies are coming back. Is that
private property contributes to social injustice.
That's right.
Single-family residences are not sustainable. I mean, these people are serious about this.
They are very serious about it. So. They are very serious about it.
What are your thoughts on the balanced budget amendment?
Yeah, and Home Depot is pushing this Dwell Green company, and they're huge in Sarasota.
I'm surprised that I like their CEO, but I think maybe he's probably not even aware of.
Another.
Bill, go ahead.
First of all, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Great sacrifice and bring some things there. I agree. I have some questions. Why didn't the House of Tallahassee introduce a verifying thing parallel to the Senate? Two.
Well, let's talk about what happened in the state. And in fairness, I think that question is probably best addressed to our Senate president because we have a supermajority in both houses in the state legislature, and nothing got done. Let me tell you that there are big special interest groups that fought it, some for different reasons. Some because they are afraid of the impact on the state's tourism hospitality industry. There is some truth, to the fact that if you implement this type of program and other states around you don't, that you're going to be in competition with them for convention business and so forth. I'm not saying that's right. I'm not saying that's not a reason to do it. Okay, it's one of the reasons that I think the federal government should do this. Okay, but I think it's a very fair question to some of the opponents I have in this race that are in Tallahassee. The agriculture, to your point, the agricultural lobby. Okay, some good friends of our whole agriculture economy in the state. Okay. Was up in arms over it, and so that big special interest group, who gives a lot of money to political candidates, I think had a huge impact on it not coming to a vote. And who was responsible for that in Tallahassee, or who behind the scenes torpedoed it? I can't answer that because I'm not in Tallahassee. But I think if we can get a federal mandated verification, we'll mute the decision.
Okay. Okay. Second question.